Hey, how's it going, Brandon? This is Holden. I said I was going to shoot you a video, and in this video, I just want to show you a few things you can do to really beat out your competition online, get some more customers in the door, and just get some more traffic to your business. Everybody's searching for what they want on Google these days, and if you can't get found in the Google search results, then you're really just not getting all the customers to your business that you want, right? And a lot of times, the only hesitation I see that business owners have to hiring someone for this sort of thing is they just don't know who the experts are and who they're not. So I found by giving out this free plan of attack, these three things that you can do and implement yourself. It's really resulted in a lot of business owners just coming back to me and saying, "Hey, Holden, I could really use your help." So, if by the end of this video, you feel like I've got some value and you want to chat, shoot me a message and we can talk. If not, that's totally fine. I just ask you, please do implement these things. They'll definitely help your business out and get you some more customers. All right, let's jump right in. I really like your logo right here. This thing's pretty nice. It's almost like a watercolor or something. So, what I want to show you here, based on your Facebook, I'm going to show you what your competition is doing with their websites getting found in Google. And the traffic that they're getting, and how easy it is going to be to beat them out and be able to get the traffic that they're getting by ranking to the top of Google. So this guy out here, he's your top competitor out there in Grayson County, and this guy's your top competitor out there in Collins County. So I want to show you, when it comes to Google optimization, the first thing that Google looks at is content. They like to see about 1,500 words of content alone on your homepage just to be optimized. Now, this is a free tool that you can pick up yourself that I use. It pulls some data off of a website. And the important metric I'm seeing here is 691 words that this guy has on his homepage. So he falls short of that 1,500 that Google really likes for optimization. So if you were to build out a website and put just 1,500 words on your homepage, you'd be beating out this guy just in that specific topic, right? This guy over here, the one in Collins, he has 1,100 words on his homepage, still falling short of that 1,500 that Google likes. So you can easily beat this guy out as well. Now, the next thing as far as content goes is something called keywords. And that's what people search in this bar up here. Anything that people search to find you, whatever your services are, arborist in Grayson, tree service in Grayson, whatever they may be, you need to make sure that you're adding those keywords into the content on your homepage. Google likes to match what people are searching with the most relevant content out there. And if that's not you, it's going to be the next guy who's going to get bumped up to the top of this list, right? Now, the next thing I want to talk to you about is something called the organic map pack. Now, this is how you get found locally, and you actually do not need a website to do this, right? You just need a Google My Business account, and you need to go out there and get your name, address, and phone number out there as many times as possible into as many directories as possible. That's things like Yellow Pages, Facebook, Yelp. And if your competition has 50 of these things, make sure you're getting 150. That way you can stay up at the top and you don't have to worry about getting bumped off this list, and not collecting all this traffic in your local area where you're probably getting most of your customers, right? So make sure you're doing that. Now, this area, this is called the organics area. The top three are where most of the conversions happen. About 60% of the people that search something in this search bar up here will click on the top three of this. Nobody's going down to where the ads are, and nobody's going to the second, third, fourth, fifth page of Google, right? So that might as well be the moon right there. But the way you look at getting up here in the top with your website is by looking at Google like a popularity contest. There's all these things called backlinks, which are kind of like popularity votes going from one website to another website all over the web. And the more of these links from other websites that you have pointing to your website, the more votes you have, the more popular you seem to Google, the more relevant they see that your content and your information is, and they'll boost you up to the top. Now, not all backlinks are created equal. You can't go get a backlink from a pizza shop linking to your arborist website, right? They know that those two don't correlate, and they'll deduct you points from that and bump you off the list. So make sure when you're finding these backlinks that you're finding links that are relevant to your industry. Next thing I want to show you, and this is the last thing, this is a tool that I pay about $1,000 a month for. It buys data directly from Google, and it's not perfect, but it does show me a lot of information about what's going on with someone's website. And what I want to show you here, this is your top competitor over there in Grayson. And this guy, he's doing no SEO or nothing to his website, and he's still ranking all the way to the top. This guy only has 13 keywords on his website that people are actually looking for. He's getting zero traffic in the Google search results. And additionally, he only has one website linking back to his website one time. Now, I'm going to show you one more, the other guy in Collin. And this guy is the guy that ranks the highest in Collins when I type in tree service in Collin County, Texas. And you can see this guy's getting found 16 times a month organically through search results. He's got 21 keywords that people are searching for. And additionally, he doesn't have any of these backlinks. And he's still at the top of the search results with no backlinks at all. So also very easily beatable that you could collect all this traffic that's coming in and more if we targeted specific keywords right. So I want to show you what keywords he's actually using. And we can look here. I don't know if you can see. So Arborist in Plano, Texas, that gets a search volume of 60 people a month search just this specific keyword. And additionally, for Frisco, Arborist Frisco, Texas, 20 searches a month. Carrollton, 20 searches a month. Tree Service in Plano, that gets 250 searches a month. So that's 250 people that could potentially be clicking on your website if you're targeting these specific keywords, right? So just to reiterate, the three things I want you to take a look at are making sure when you get your website is 1,500 words on your homepage of content alone, and then additionally adding those keywords that people are searching for, the ones with all that traffic, you know, these 250 volume a month traffic for that specific area. And then next, I want you to make sure that you're going out and getting those directories, your name, address, and phone number as many times as possible into different directories to get up in this map pack and get found locally. And then additionally, to get into this sweet spot up here where most of the conversion happens, at the top of the organics, you need to go out and finding those backlinks I was telling you about, you know, making sure that you're finding relevant backlinks that have to do with your industry and will give you some more push to the top. So I hope this was helpful. And like I said, if you want to chat some more, shoot me a message. And if not, please just let me know what you thought of the video. I'd really appreciate it. I love hearing back from you. So, all right. Thanks a lot. Have a good one.